It's very easy in the world that we live in to forget who we are and to get focused on the pressures of life. Amen? It's very easy to live day to day and get caught up in the rat race or survivor race, you know, because the truth is that man must survive. Is that not so? Man must survive. And we can get caught up in man survive, women live. Amen? Man must survive, but women, they live. So when a man is talking about man must survive, he's not thinking of himself alone, right? As you are surviving, you're making sure that the woman beside you is living. Amen. Glory be to God. Seth, I like your answer very well. That means you're working hard. Glory be to God. But you see, in the scripture, every time God tells us, you know, remind us of the things that ought to be important to us, it is because it's obvious that we can easily allow those things to slip away. And in quotes, reorder our priorities. Amen. Reorder our priorities. So I titled today's message, What We Ought to Do. Amen. What we ought to do. In Hebrews chapter 2 from verse 1, you know, God counseled us. You put that on the board. God counseled us and he said, therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. Say, we need to pay more attention. We need to give credence. We need to give time to the things that we have heard, to the truth that we have heard. Says we need to pay attention to the truth that we have heard. Why? Because truth has a tendency to leak. Amen? The truth that you know today, if you don't hold it very tight, very soon you'll find out that the truth has leaked away. And the way you know that truth has leaked away, it's seen in your conduct and in your life. Glory be to God. It's the reason why sometimes people compromise. It's the reason why sometimes standards are lowered. It's just a case that the truth is slipping out. It's leaking away. You know, there are things that, you know, probably some days behind we wouldn't have even tolerated. But, you know, as you stay on, that's why it is said that, you know, it's a proverb in Africa, you know, if you stay too long in toilet, the smell of toilet will begin to smell like perfume. It's a proverb, I don't know how to say it. What I mean is that it will begin to smell good to you. You will not run away from it again. But the first time you enter, you'll be like, what is this? You move away. But stay there for a long time. You will not act like that again. Your nose will adjust. You adjust to the smell, and you will stay there. Have you ever seen people living close to the dump, you know, where they dump refuse and things like that? What happens when you go to visit them the first time? You're like, God, are you coping here? But they've lived there for years. They don't smell it again. It has become part of them. That is the same way truth slips out. Or what you hold dear, you can begin to do what? Let it go. It's the fact of life. Glory be to God. You know, if you don't want to eat something, don't begin to stay close to the thing, because when the smell enters your nose too much, what do you think will happen? You should say, can I taste it? It's the truth. What you don't like, move away. Growing up, I've known people who say, you are always with this guy. And the girl will tell you, no, we are just friends. But you're always with this guy. I say, no, he's just my friend. There's nothing. I don't like him. Can't you see his nose? Can't you see his head? They tell you everything wrong, but they ended up marrying the person. That's the truth. I've seen it 20 times. Now, can't you see the nose? Can't you see the yab, but there'll always be this person. Ah, no, you'll marry him very soon. You know why? If you stay long, let me not use all the proverbs so that you won't take the message away. If you stay long with a baboon can become very fine. We say there's different proverbs. I'm telling you, different things can look nice to you. It's just you spending time and looking at it. It will change. Just think about it. Something that you didn't like before that you now like. Just think about it. Whether it's food, it's dress, it's something. Just think about it. There are things that you did not like growing up. But the more you spend time with that thing, you just find out that it will change. And it's just life. It is just life. And the reason why is what God is telling us. If you don't hold something very dear to you, you know, nobody forgets. You don't say you don't forget something that is not important. Would you forget anything that is not important to you? You don't even try to, you know. But the thing that you forget, that you say, oh, I forgot, that means that thing was important. You say, oh, when you remember, I forgot, it's because it was important. Why do we forget things that are important? It is because we didn't pay attention to it again. We allow it to slip. It's not as if it wasn't important to us. But important things can slip away. Things that we ought to give, you know, time, attention to, we can allow it slip. It's just life. Amen? See? And there is the only way we can begin to handle this thing and to make sure that important things don't slip away. It's one of the things, that's why we have so many things. Memory pad, you know, you write things down. You know why you're writing them down? You don't want to forget. You don't want to slip. You don't want it to slip away. You don't want tomorrow, we set an alarm for different things. We put reminders for different things. We do all that. Why? It's because we don't want that thing to slip away. It's important. Glory be to God. Because it doesn't matter how you say something is important, you can forget. You can forget it. Glory be to God. Heard of a woman that forgot the child at the park. How is that possible? How is that possible? Yeah, things just, I forgot the child at the park. Just, I'm like, really? Now, we might look at that and say, oh, she's weird, this something, this one, and begin to judge her and condemn her and say everything. But I promise you, it's very easy for you to also do what? Forget important thing. You can forget. Amen? So you set alarm, you set a reminder, you do all that for the sake of remembering what is important to you. And it's the same thing that God is instructing us. God wants us to do what? To find a way to make sure that we don't allow what is important to us to slip away. Glory be to God. You're welcome, sir. You're welcome, ma'am. God wants you to pay attention to, and it's not everything that is important that should be important to you. There are things that you should give credence to. And the number one thing that we should give credence to as a believer is the word of God. Amen? Number one thing we should give credence to is the word of God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And the way we know that, you know, we're not giving credence to it, the way you know that you have forgotten is when there is an attitudinal change or behavioral change. You know, if the way you behave is now changing, then know that something, you know, you're beginning to forget certain things. For example, if you always have to be probably at the gym every Monday, 7 p.m., and for some reason you have not been going for some weeks, then you know that something is changing in your, whether in your schedule or the way you prioritize going to the gym. Is that not so? You know something is changing. There's a reason why, you know, that thing is changing. Now, It is not starting something like we know that is the hard part. It's sustaining what we start. Many of us start gym, go 1, 2, 3 months, you know, and we're very, very consistent. By the time it's running to 5, 6 months, you know, we'll now be going, the thing will slide. Does it mean that the reason why we're going before has changed? No. That's just, it's just, see, there are times that you hold fast to a truth. That there are periods in your life that you appreciate a truth and you run with it. There are knowledge that comes to you that when it comes, you really appreciate it. Sometimes you can, let's even forget going to the gym. You know, there are certain financial, what would I call it now? You can get a wink of how to do certain things and break through financially. But you know that to do that requires a lot of discipline. It's okay, no, I'm going to divide my income into three and make sure that I always save one third. And so you do the first month, you do the second month, you do the third month, and as you're going down, you know, but you had a goal when you started. There's something, certain thing you wanted to accomplish. But as you move on, you just find out that you start defaulting. It's not because something has changed. It's because the way the truth hits you the first time is gradually leaking out. It's leaking out. And when the truth leaks out, what you notice is behavioral change. Certain things begin to change. You're not as diligent as you used to be concerning that thing. You're not as passionate. You're not. The drive is no longer like that again. It is because, you see, it's not because the human being is bad. It's not because the person is wicked. No. The person is defaulting just because, you see, the way the truth hit him the first time is not the same way that it is today. Truths leak. Glory be to God. That conviction begins to fade off. That's so, see, we make New Year resolution. Why do we do it in the first place? Because we know that it's important. We know that it's something good, right? But by April, what happens? It's gone. It is gone. And God doesn't want us to be ignorant of the way the world is or the way Satan deals with the children of God. God doesn't want us to be ignorant of how things operate and begin to cause us to move away from who we ought to be and become a person that we didn't desire or plan to be in life. That's the reason why sometimes, and that's why I started by saying, you'll be surprised at what you abhor in the first place, you can begin to embrace. What will irritate you before, all of a sudden, you can tolerate. Why? You just stayed long there, you'll begin to tolerate it. And God doesn't want the truth to leak. So he tells us, glory be to God, if you put that scripture again on the board. So he tells us to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. For if, let's go all the way to 3, say, for if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience receive a just recompense of reward. Verse 3, he tells us, he said, how shall we escape? Talking about the new light. We'll come to that. If the one that was spoken by angels, you know, the Old Testament was spoken and all that, he says, how shall we escape, you know, if we neglect so great a salvation in the world that we live in today, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him. Said God also bearing them witness, both with signs and wonders and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost, according to his own will. Glory be to God. Brothers and sisters, it's easy to forget something. And it's not because you're not a good person or you're a bad person. That's why you forget. And don't beat yourself when you forget something. See, you can forget things and oh God, why that? And get angry with yourself. That's not a remedy for it. Glory be to God. Because if that's all you do, you will forget again. Glory be to God. All that you need to do is to find a way of remembering things. Finish. Either you write it down, or you paste it on your fridge, or you paste it where you sit. Do anything you have to do to remind yourself. Don't beat yourself about forgetting things. Don't be angry and beat yourself down. Oh, I could have forgotten that. And all. If that's all you do when you forget something, it's not going to change. It is not going to change. Devise a means of you remembering what you have to do. Glory be to God. And the world is full of with technology, things that you can use to remind yourself the things that you ought to do. So many offices, they give you different things. Why? They want you to keep tab of things that you ought to do, that you don't lose sight of them. Glory be to God. Have you ever done project managing before? That's the way it's done. When you're breaking down a project, you break them down in dates with taxes and different things. This must be done by this date, by that date. This must have been accomplished. If this fails, that means the other one is likely to fail. And all that is broken down. Glory be to God. I mean, I enjoy project management when I did that, you know. Because it can tell you, you can project the future. You can know. Why do we do all that? Why is all that done? It is because so that you can keep tab of how things are progressing, so that one aspect would not slip away. Because in the midst of a big project, it is possible for one important thing to be forgotten. And so everything is documented and put on the board. And every time it is done, you check it. Check. 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 Why? It's so that you make sure that you have everything in perspective. Glory be to God. We can walk with God like that. We can walk the Christian walk or the Christian race like that. We can have ways that we remember the things that God wants us to do or who God wants us to be in life. Glory be to God. There are ways. I love, you see, today it's easy. You don't like reading? You can listen. Glory be to God. The Bible has been, there are audio Bibles in different versions. There's the drama one, there's the classic, there's any type you want. The song that as you're listening, it feels as if you're there and it's like a drama. And you can enjoy listening to it, amen? Glory be to God. And one of the reasons why you listen is so that it can stay with you. It's so that it's fresh with you. You know, it doesn't just slip away. And that's why the Bible tells us that faith cometh by hearing. It didn't say faith cometh by, or have faith cometh having heard. No. It's a continuous thing. Glory be to God. You have to keep hearing. The proof that we have not forgotten is that our life, our behavior and conduct is controlled by that truth. In as much as our behavior and our conduct is controlled by the truth that we know, then be sure that you have not forgotten. It's fresh in you. But if it is no longer controlling it, then know that something, you know, is missing. So it tells us to give the most earnest heed to the things that, you know, that the word of God that we've heard. Glory be to God. Why is it necessary? Let me read a scripture to us in Acts 20 and 32. You can put that on the board. Acts 20 and 32. So it tells us. Is that Acts 20? Is it 3 or 32? 32. Okay. I was wondering. He said, I said, and now, brethren, I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you an inheritance among them that are sanctified. Amen. Let me break down that scripture. It says, among them that are sanctified are people that have been set apart by God, people that have been called by God. And if you're a child of God, you're sanctified, you're called by God. Amen? So he's referring to the church, he's referring to believers, he's referring to everyone that is a child of God who has been set apart from the world and called unto himself. Glory be to God. So he tells us, Paul was writing, says, I commend you. He said, brethren, I commend you, I hand you over, I give you this, take this. He said, to the word, he said, unto the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you an inheritance among the saints. Now, according to this scripture, it's possible for one to be among the sanctified and not partake in the inheritance, right? Because it says to build you up and to do what? And give you. In other words, when you're built up, you take your inheritance. Then you take your inheritance. See, the things grace has already provided, you know, everything that God has in store for us. And the way we will take the things or our inheritance, our rights, the things that Jesus died to give to us, is through the word of his grace dwelling richly in us. So he said, I commend to you, I give unto you, I commend unto you the word of his grace. The word of his grace. The message of his grace. The knowledge of his grace. The things that he has given to you. The things that he has done for you. So you begin to speak in the light of the things and you begin to hold on to the truth and to the promises of the things that he has given to you. He says, I commend to you, hold on to this. Stay true with this, to the word of his grace. He says, this is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among the saints. Why? Because says, it says, the heir, if he be a child, say he differeth not from a servant or from a slave. He cannot do what? Enjoy his inheritance. He can enjoy his inheritance. It's his. But he can enjoy it. He can't step into it. He can, you know, he can lay hold on it. Glory be to God. And Paul called the believers and said, hey, brothers and sisters, I commend to you the word of his grace. Take the word of his grace. Keep it in your heart. Let this word remain in you. Let this word build you up so that you can enjoy everything that there is for us to enjoy as believers. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. There are so many. David said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefits. Glory be to God. Why? Because there are benefits for us that are called unto him. Say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and everything within me, bless his holy name. Say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not just his benefit, all of his benefits. Glory be to God. In other words, you can forget it. You can forget. And the way you forget is by not following what he has said. Glory be to God. It's because the truth leaks away. Hallelujah. And when the truth leaks away, there's no way you can get the benefits of the truth. You cannot receive the benefit. The benefit comes with the truth, staying fresh in you. Paul says the word of his grace, I commend you to build you up, to take, put you in a place of your inheritance. Glory be to God. We don't have to struggle like the world struggles, no. Otherwise, the death of Jesus Christ will be in vain. Our labor is in Christ. Glory be to God. We labor to believe his word. We labor to believe his promises. We labor to accept the things that he has freely given to us. Glory be to God. And so he tells us, says, focus on that. Now, if I want to jump a little bit on my messages, let's go to James chapter 1 and verse 22. still speaking in the light of when David said, you know, to bless the Lord, O my soul, and his everything within me, bless his holy name, and say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. In other words, bring yourself to remember the things that God has said. Bring yourself, don't forget the ways of the Lord. Let the word of God stay fresh in you. Let the word of God be readily accessible in your mind so that it can direct or control your life. Because when somebody is acting contrary to what he knows, the Bible says, this one has forgotten. And the one that the Bible calls the doer of God's word, the Bible says, is the man that remembers the word. Glory be to God. The Bible says we should be what? Hearers and doers of the word. But he tells us who the doer of the word is. He says the one that remembers, that is the one that is the doer of the word. Why? Because the reason why we do not do is because we have forgotten. Glory be to God. If we forget, then we will not act accordingly. And the blessing or the benefit will not accrue to us. We can't take our inheritance. So it tells us, it says, in verse 22, it says, but be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any be a hearer of the word, and not a doer, say, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholded himself, and goeth his way, and straightway forgets. Amen? Say, forget what manner of man he was. Say, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, he be not a forgetful hearer. In other words, he remembers. Look at what the Bible says. He said, but a doer of the work. Say, this man shall be blessed in his deed. In other words, he said, he be not a forgetful hearer. Once you are not a forgetful hearer, automatically you'll be a doer of the work. You will do what you remember. You cannot do what you do not remember. It is not possible. Glory be to God. And not to do the word of God means that we forgot or it slipped away. And so Hebrews said, told us again, move back to Hebrews chapter 2. It says, hallelujah. It says, therefore, say we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time they slip away. Why? Because when it slips away, the word of his grace would not be in our lips again. We will begin to speak the pressure we are facing, the challenges, you know, our experience. That's all we'll be speaking. We can no longer talk about what God has done for us, but we begin to talk about what God is going to do based on our experience. And like I tell people, your experience does not validate the word of God. I'm just telling you, your experience doesn't validate the word of God. Amen. I know you're looking at me strange. Glory be to God. Look, I might be feeling sick in my body. It doesn't change the fact that God heals. I might go to heaven and never get healed of a sickness. It doesn't mean that God is not a healer. Is that not true? Amen. I know for a fact. So, irrespective of how I feel in my body, it doesn't change my conviction and the truth of God's word that I know that God heals. Hallelujah. See, my bank account does not tell me that God has prospered me. Glory be to God. It's not the indication that I'm a prosperous man. Because irrespective of what is in my account, God has prospered me. Hallelujah. So, what we are seeing or what we are experiencing, what is going on around us, It's not what we use to judge whether God's word is true. We don't do that. Because to do that is to fail or to have a shipwreck of faith. We stand with what God has said. You see, I like the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I say, look, don't get it mixed up. Our God is able to do what? To deliver us. Understand, O King, our God can save us. But if he chooses not to, just in case it is not one of the things that in his will should be done right now, I'd rather burn up. You know that? Okay. So don't understand, though. We know he's able to save us. It doesn't take anything for him to save us. Glory be to God. And see, brothers and sisters, that must be our views of God's word to us. Except we hold fast this word of his grace concerning us, we will always swing like a pendulum, depending on what our experience is. So when everything looks good, we will shout hallelujah. Before I say hallelujah, it would have been chorused amen. But the day the pendulum swings in the other direction, the hallelujah would have gone before. So the hallelujah would have been 5 minutes ago before your amen will now remember to say it. Glory be to God. And when we are like that, that means that we are still relating with God based on our experience, based on what we see. We change our experience by the word of God. We use the word of God to change our experience. And the way we use the word of God to change our experience is to make sure that we do not forget what the word says. And not to forget what the word says is to make sure that you stop every leakage, every area that the word of God can pass to leak from you. Because there are ways that the word can pass. So the Bible tells us, say, be careful what you hear. Why? Because what you're hearing can corrupt what is in your heart. Glory be to God. Can corrupt it. Can corrupt your faith. Say, be careful what you're watching. Be careful what you're seeing. Be careful where you go to. Be careful where you hang out. Be careful the kind of companies that you keep. Be careful. Why? Because all these are agents, you know, that causes the word of God to do what? To slip away, to leak. To leak. And brothers and sisters, what makes us who we are in Christ is the word of God in our hearts. That word that we have. That word that we have. The people of the world, they don't have it. And they cannot even have it. The Bible tells us, say the things of God are not naturally discerned. Say, but they are spiritually discerned. It's only one that is born of God that can receive the word of God. The word of God cannot make sense to the man out there. It makes sense to us. It's foolishness to the people out there. But to us is the wisdom of God in this world that we are living in. So we let go of the world's wisdom and do what? And hold on to God's wisdom for us. See, because there are many things that will happen before you that if you want to use your experience to explain it, it will not match the word of God. So just do what? Forget your experience. Glory be to God. Forget your experience. And just trust that if this is what God says, then it's true. The Bible tells us concerning Abraham. It says, Abraham did not in any way consider his body, you know, not functioning again or now old, nor Sarah's womb that was completely dead. He said, but still he believed God and believed his promises, that the one who has promised is able to do. So the Bible says, he staggered not at these things that he was seeing. You know why? Because you look left, you look right, you won't see where the help will come from. You don't know how it's going to be done. And the natural tendency is to speak contrary and say, I don't think God can do this. I don't think this can happen. Maybe it's not just my lot. Maybe it's not just what I... maybe this is not meant for me. But the Bible tells us that if God has promised, say his word will not fall to the ground without it accomplishing the purpose for which it was spoken, I will stay there until the word of God is performed in my life. I hold on to God's word, his promises for me, until it's true in my life. Glory be to God. I don't let it go. I don't let it slip away. Jesus said this. He said, the word that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. You know when they say something is spirit and it's life? It goes beyond. It goes beyond the natural things that we see. Glory be to God. And it produces life in us. But in other words, death is working every time. That's the system of the world. Death is there working. But the thing that stops death from working in us is that word of God inside of us. So the Bible tells us, Jesus said, "Say the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." Some other place he tells us, he said, and he sent his word. And his word did what? Heal them. Amen. Why? The word, there's no natural barrier to the word. See, and he sent his word, and his word healed them of all their diseases. Why? Because the word is spiritual. Glory be to God. And it's alive. It causes death to flee. Where the word of God is, death cannot reign. Death cannot prevail. It moves fast away. Glory be to God. Encourage us. Encourage us. Look to the word. Look to the word. So be not a forgetful hearer. Check in your life. There are ways that the truth of God's word has been slipping away. Any area of your, check. In which area are you passive when it comes to the word of God? In which area are you passive when it comes to being, you know, doing things for God? Walking according to the word of God? Obeying the word of God? In which area are you passive? Check again. The truth is that you're passive because the word has been leaking. Go and block it. Glory be to God. Block it. You know, it doesn't matter how big a tank or whatever container is, and it's filled with water. If there is a hole, it's just a matter of time. What will happen? It will be empty. That container, that tanker, whatever it is, say it's a million, whatever can contain so and so a million, a cubic volume. What? It might not be empty in 1 year. Amen. It might be empty in 5 years. It's just going to take some time. It will be empty. Glory be to God. It will be empty. It's just a matter of time. It will be empty. You don't want it to be empty? Block where it's leaking from. Seal it. There are people in your life you just have to walk away from, causing the truth of God's word to leak. Glory be to God. There are places where you go to, constantly causing the word of God to leak out. Check it. Whatever thing that is causing God's word to leak where you are, make sure you seal it. See, for us to expect deliverance, for us to expect a miracle, for us to expect the help of God, when we neglect the word of God, is ridiculous. Telling the truth. It is a ridiculous mindset. You can put that Hebrews again. Let's go to verse 3. Look at what the Lord says here, you know. So he tells us, he says, how shall we escape? In other words, how can you be delivered? How can you be set free? If we neglect so great a salvation or the help that God has already made available, how can we? He says, which at the first began to be spoken, talking about the word, if you go back to the word. So talking about if we neglect what? So great a salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him. Say, God also bearing them witness, both with signs and wonders and with diverse miracles and the gift of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. How can we escape, brothers and sisters, if we neglect the word of his grace? How can we be helped? Why should we expect miracle? Why should we expect the help of God? Why do we still expect God to show up when we are not walking or causing the truth of God's word to leak in our lives? Says, why? Why? That's to deceive ourselves. Glory be to God. Look, go back to verse 1. Now let's look at what he said. It tells us that the people before us were not spared. Amen? Look at it. He said, therefore we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time they should sleep, we should let them sleep up. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward. In other words, every disobedience, everyone, every transgression, everyone that did not take heed to this, say they did not escape the recompense of reward. In other words, they got exactly what they wanted by neglecting. And so going forward, it now tells us, go to verse 3 now. That's what I said. Then it tells us, say, how shall we, if the people of yesteryears, the people of the Old Testament, if they did not escape, hey, meanwhile, ours is better. Because this is where we come to say, we say, oh, no. The Old Testament, there was no grace. This is grace. I agree. I'm not disputing. But he says, how shall we escape if we neglect so great, our salvation is greater than theirs. Why? Because of the blood of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. See, the payment for us is greater and is won for a lifetime. Glory be to God. There is no payment again that needs to be made. It's not like the yesteryears that they have to do it every year. Sacrifice has to be made every year. It's no longer needed to be done again for us. But we cannot afford to do what? Neglect the sacrifice. It is true, the blood of Jesus speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. The blood of Jesus superior. The deliverance of Jesus ultimate is absolute. Glory be to God. It needs nothing else to be added or subtracted. The blood of Jesus Christ is perfect for all, but you can't afford to neglect it. You can't receive salvation or deliverance if you neglect it. You can't refuse what he has done, or you can't neglect what he has done and still expect salvation or deliverance. And that's what he's telling us. If we expect the miracle of God, we expect the hand of God, then let's hold fast to the word of his grace. Let's hold fast. Let's make sure that it doesn't leak away. Let's ensure that it stays with us. Let's ensure that it stays with us. I close with this scripture. 1 Corinthians and chapter 15. Say, moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preach unto you, which also you have received and wherein you stand. You preach unto you, you receive it, you preach it, and you stand by it. Amen? Say, by which also you are saved. That's what brought salvation for us. Amen? Says, if you keep in what? Can you read that with me? In memory what I preached unto you. Unless, what happens? To forget is to have believed in vain, brothers and sisters. To forget. Not to keep in memory is to forget. And to forget is to have believed in vain. May we not believe in vain. Glory be to God. Now that scripture says, that which you have heard will be required of us. When it says it will be required of us, it means it will stand in the time of trial. It will be like a witness against us. Glory be to God. You know, you can't claim ignorance if you have been told. Is that not true? You can't go to the law court and say, I was ignorant. They say, no, you were served a notice. You were told. Ignorance is what automatically thrown out of the door. The only time you can claim ignorance is when you are not told. But if you have been told and you refuse to keep it in memory, that's on you. That's on you. And everything will be conducted on the premise that you were duly informed. You were duly informed. So the Bible says, that which we hear will be required of us. It's required because it's given to us so that we can model, conduct our lives. You know, we can begin to shape our life in line with that which we hear, that which the word of God has instilled in our heart. We have a responsibility to live by it. Amen. And as long as you live by it, I tell you, you don't need to bind Satan. Satan will be bound in your life. Glory be to God. You don't need anybody to lay hands on you or do anything. Why? The word of God is enough. The word of God is enough to produce in you. I'm telling you the truth. You pay attention to the word of God. You don't need to pray for deliverance. Deliverance is already with you. Because the word of God sets free. The Bible says, you know the truth and the truth shall set you free. God, you don't need to pray having received the truth. The truth has what it takes to do what? Set you free. That's what God wants for us. Amen. And I pray for us that even as we hear the word this morning, that we will know what it is to hold on to it. I pray that in every area of your life, you will know what it is to seek the promises of God, the provision of God, the covenant that we have with God, so that you can declare it again and cause it to work in your life. I pray that the word of God will be before your eyes, to be on your lips, to be in your heart. It will not be far from you, in the name of Jesus Christ. That in the times, in moments of challenges and in moments of need, rather than speak according to the ways of the world, you will speak according to the word of God. Your stand will be the stand of God. Your confidence will be in God. And your hope will be anchored on the word of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you. Just like Abraham said, and the Bible tells us that he staggered not at the promises of God. I pray that you will not stagger at the promises of God. I pray that all that God has revealed to you, all that God has promised you, all that God has shown to you, you will know what it is to hold tight until it's made manifest in your life. It doesn't matter how long it takes, stay there. If God promised, he's faithful, he will do it. And I pray for you that you have the courage, you have the patience, you have the boldness to hold on to God in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For we know that God's word is truth, and is the truth that is able to set us free. So, Father, we thank you. For we are set free, and we are free indeed. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Why don't you take your tithe and your offering and just bless it and let's give it. Hallelujah. Is our time correct? Is it late? Oh, is our time correct? Oh, really? Miracles happen. I actually preached for 45 minutes or 50 minutes. That's a miracle. I'm not ending after 12. Oh, really? Amen. Glory be to God. Now, this week, I'm sure that either one way or the other, we would like to know which of the four cardinal points of the three cardinal areas you're volunteering for our 2020 vision. Amen. So whether it's through text messages, whether through email or one of those things, you know, or all that will come out so that, you know, we can get everybody signed into one area. At least you must serve in one area, amen? A member of the house, that means God has given you skills, wisdom, and understanding, and you're able to do it, amen? Glory be to God. Just lift your envelopes up as we provide. Father, we thank you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for our tithe and our offering we're giving to you. Lord, we thank you for causing it to be multiplied back to us in the name of Jesus. We thank you because we receive 100-fold. And I pray for everyone, O Lord, that even as we give, Lord, that the devourer is rebuked for their sake in the name of Jesus Christ. That the enemy takes his hands off their property, of their finances, of their health, of their home, their peace, their joy. Thank you, Lord, because your abundance, oh God, is over every household. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name.